Okay, here is the video of these shots. Just jump straight out here and shoot all these balls just the way they're setting. They're all half ball shots to either one of these two pockets. Then I'll explain why or how you can use this and how it really doesn't have anything to do with the Poolology. That's how I came across it, but it still works. I'll shoot them where I don't have to move any of the other balls. So we'll shoot the 8 ball first. I'll cut it over there. Or I can shoot the 3 and get it out of the way. It doesn't matter. They're half ball shots. So I'm going to aim straight through the center of the cue ball. Split my tip on the edge of the ball. I'm not going to stun it, because a stun shot will push the object ball a little bit and make it hit fat, and I'll miss the pocket. I'm not going to put any spin on it. I'm just going to go above center, roll through the ball so it hits it while it's rolling. Free ball over there, I guess. I can put the 9 ball in the same pocket, or I can put it over there. Doesn't really matter. I like the back cuts. We'll back cut it. Another half ball shot. So, put some balls out here. All I'm doing is using this end rail. Anytime you have a ball out in the middle of the table and the cue ball is straight on with it or pointed anywhere onto this end rail, you can use this little method. Pretty handy method. Anytime there's a ball in this area. It even works back in here. It just takes a little more visualization on how to break the ball up, but I'll show you what I mean. Derek, you had a question about how this ties into Poolology, because in the Poolology book, this is 40, not the center of the table, but half a diamond from there over to this pocket. And then from that pocket to this diamond is 50. So I'll tell you why, how this became 40 in the Poolology book, whereas this used to be, and it's not the right number. And I'll tell you why. If I call this 40, it works really, really accurate for any ball. This is 20 and center of the table is going to be 40. Any ball on here aimed at there is a half ball. But any ball on this line aimed for this second diamond is not a really accurate half ball to the pocket. This 40 is more accurate for that diamond. And if I were use the center of the table is more accurate for that diamond. But any ball on this line or that line aimed at that diamond center to center is a half ball of that pocket. So it's better to use this line because it's more accurate for this diamond. So, and what I mean is when you have a ball sitting here and I'm lined for there, it's going to go in the pocket. If I were over here with the cue ball line for there, it's still a half ball shot that's going to go into the pocket. The thing is, if it were here, it's still a half ball shot using that diamond from here to put it in that pocket. From over here, now a half ball shot is going to cause the 3 ball to hit right there, because it's up here closer to what the Poolology book would call a 46, 45. So I would have, for a half ball shot, I'd have to be lined at about a 22 or 23, and I'd have to be right in there. Now it's a half ball shot. So in order for the second diamond to be used for a value of 40, either that second diamond or this one, in the book, this has to be 40. Not that. But that's not what we're doing here. All I'm doing is using the center of the table and that end rail. I'm ignoring the side rails. Because I'm talking about shots that just come up that are out here like this. You know? You may have left yourself like that. It's a pretty easy shot. So it's more like that right there. The thing is, I know any ball that's in the center of the table, anywhere from about here all the way over to there, any ball that's in here, even if it's 2 inches this way, even if it's all the way to this diamond, so anywhere in this little triangle area there, any ball in there, aimed at that diamond is a half ball shot to this pocket. If it were in this little diamond, it's a half ball shot to that pocket. Just happens to be this line is shared by both of those diamonds. So anything on this line aimed at here is a half ball to either pocket. Doesn't matter. So I'll put a ball out here. Set the cue ball right even with it. That's a half ball shot to either pocket. Now what I described in the post was that for every half diamond closer to the targeted pocket, so now let's say, instead of my center line landing here, it lands there. Let's use that first. Say my center line now lands half a diamond closer to the pocket. So I want to come over here and adjust it. Now I'm there. What this just became was a 5/8 shot, because every half diamond closer to the pocket means my aim has to be thicker. If it's all the way over and I'm straight into here like this, it's a straight in shot. Half a diamond over is a 7/8. Another half diamond over, which is here, right there, is a 3/4. Another diamond over, or half a diamond, is a 5/8. Another half diamond is a half ball shot. So everything from a half ball thicker, every half diamond down there tells me to aim 1/8 of an aim point thicker. And so from this shot, it's going to be a 5/8. Instead of aiming to split my tip on the edge of the object ball for a half ball shot, I'm aiming for my entire shaft and tip to be pointed through the cue ball, just flush inside the ball, where this side of my shaft, if I could stroke it all the way to that three ball through the cue, the outside part of my shaft over here is even. It's flush with the outer edge of the three. And my whole tip would make an imprint just inside the left side of that three. Oops. That's the 5/8 book, according to the Poolology book. So that's going to be right here. It's going to shoot it the same way. I'm going to roll through it. I'm not going to stun the shot or I'll miss it. I'm going to roll through this ball at the 5/8 aim. And I may hit these a little, not as accurate as I'd like to hit them, because I'm usually not strictly using a system like this. It comes in great and it's handy for shots like this when they come up and you're nervous and you see this and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm out of line. But this is a dead half ball shot. There or there, because I'm lying to that diamond. And just knowing that will help you out in so many games, it's ridiculous. From there to 5/8, from there to 3/4, going to this pocket. Now, we'll use this pocket for our target. So I know now if I'm lying for here, and I'm in the center of the table, anywhere in there, and the center of the line leads here, it's a half ball shot to either pocket. If I go toward my target pocket, a half a diamond, it's an eighth of an aim, eighth of a ball, thicker of an aim. Let's say in the book now, not the book, but in the post, I said every 3/4 of a diamond, which would be, there's a half, so there's 3/4. Another 3/4 would be halfway between here and there. So right in there. This ends up being an eighth on the thin side. So if I aim here, that's really what's happening here. Is the reason why any ball in this area aimed there will go. Because the pocket, these pockets are a little bit, they're 4.5 inches. Right there in the front, just like that. The same 4.5 inches, this distance away from the four ball, it's going to be right in here somewhere, is this big. So I can be anywhere between this piece of chalk and this piece of chalk, and it's still going to be a half ball shot into the corner pocket. Right there is going to make it a pretty close to center pocket. If I'm lying for that and then aim at a half ball, it's going to go center pocket in either way. But I've got this much play that I can be off. So the same thing applies out here on this 3/8 ball shot. If I'm lying for here, which is 3/4 of a diamond over, then I'm going to aim a whole 1/8 of an aim point thinner than a half ball. So from here, it will be a half ball shot. From here, it's a 3/8. On a 3/8, my entire shaft, if I could stroke it all the way through the cue ball, my entire shaft would be flush against the outside of that ball, touching it, if I could stroke it that far. So now this side of my shaft is all nice and neat, flushed up against the outside of the ball. Whereas the 5/8 was just the opposite. It's all flush inside the edge of the ball. So from here, this is a 3/8 ball shot. I'm just going to roll right through that again. Rattling them up. And that ball didn't hit the pocket. It wasn't because it doesn't work. It's because I didn't hit the aim point. These are my first shots of the day, by the way. So there it is. I'm lined up straight for that piece of chalk. It should be a 3/8 ball shot. I'll pay more attention. Stroking all the way through this ball. It doesn't matter where the ball is sitting. It could be sitting here, and I'm lying right there for the 3/8. That's still a 3/8 ball shot. Right there. That's a 3/8 ball shot to the corner, just like this. That doesn't matter. If it was sitting over here, it's in the center of the table. It could be give or take an inch or two. That doesn't really make that much of a difference. If it's down this far, it does, because it's all based on the first thing I was showing, this little area there. If I'm going to that pocket, I've only got this little triangle area. So over here, it can be, I've got a bigger room. From over here, it's right in there. But anywhere on this line is good. So if I'm aimed here now, if I'm lined up straight to that 3/4 of a way, it's a 3/8 ball shot over there again. Let's say I have to do it because it looks like that. And I'm going to cut the 7 over there because it won't go down there. I'm aiming right at the 3/8 aim. I catch my breath, all that talking, and bend it straight over. Here we go. So, it's pretty accurate. This would be a quarter ball shot going to that pocket. So if this ball were out here, and I'm here, it's a quarter ball shot. If it were over here, and I were lying for here, that's a quarter ball shot. It's the same angle. Doesn't look like it. That's what makes shots out in the middle of the table more tricky than a ball that's sitting like this that you have to cut down the rail. These are easy shots. Once you shoot enough of them, these become very easy because this is a nice visual aid. You're up here looking at this ball and you can see the path the five ball's got to take. This is it, the rail. A ball out here in the middle of the table, you don't have that nice, easy little visual to look at. From here, I know that that ball's got to taper with the rail. From out here, I have nothing close to it. It's just out in the middle of nowhere, so they're trickier shots. So with all of that said, I don't want to talk too much. So I'm looking at these shots now. They're both quarter ball shots to that pocket. Some of them you may not want to shoot if you're playing. It might be a smarter shot than cutting this ball over there. But if it's the game ball and you have to make it, and there are no safeties to play, this comes up and you look right at it and you go, oh, I don't know where that is. If I were shooting into this pocket and line for that piece of chalk, I'm only half a diamond out. So it's 1/8 of an aim. So instead of being a full ball hit, it's a 7/8. So here I would just aim 1/8 of a ball to the right of center, and it's going to go in the pocket. From here I would aim 1/8 of a ball right of center, it's going to go in the pocket. But for that pocket, I am 2/8 away from a half ball line. Meaning that if I were here, line for the second diamond, it's a half ball shot over there, or over there, doesn't matter. But let's say I'm picking this pocket over there. From here, it's a half ball. From here, it's a 3/8. And from here, it's a quarter. So going thicker, every half diamond is 1/8 of an aim point adjustment. Going thinner, every 3/4 of a diamond. But the same theory applies. The pocket is this wide, so really, I've got that much room. It doesn't have to be dead on that, but that is closer to center pocket. As I start getting off to the side of here or here, I'm taking a chance on hitting this edge or that edge. Same way with the quarter ball shot. Quarter ball shot's a little more tricky. With the 5/8 and the 3/8 and the half, everything is geared around the outer edge of the ball. It's such a visual. It's right there. You can't miss the outer edging of that ball. The outermost surface that you can see standing here. A half ball, you split your tip on it. A 5/8, the entire tip is just inside the edge of the ball. A 3/8, it's all just outside the edge. For a quarter ball shot, we'll set both of these back up. I'm just lining up for that quarter ball piece of chalk over there. So for a quarter ball shot, you're actually aiming to where this side of my shaft is about 3/10 of a way. If I could follow all the way through after I stroke this ball, my shaft is going to be about 3/10 of an inch away from the edge of the ball. A 3/8, it's flush. A 3/8 aim. A quarter ball aim, the edge of my shaft is just about 3/10. It takes practice. And these are the kind of things that the more you practice them, you find yourself not quite trying to do them anymore. Your brain catches on and it becomes automatic, like riding a bicycle. The harder you try to do something, usually the worse you do at it. But that's how we have to learn. You consciously make an effort to learn how to do it, and eventually it becomes a subconscious action. So the balls that I miss, if I miss some of these shots, it's because I'm not subconsciously just getting up there and shooting the balls like I'm used to doing. I'm consciously trying to aim at a certain point, and that's the hardest way to play anything, to play any game. But we'll shoot these quarter ball shots over to there. I'll shoot this one first so I don't run into them. So this is going to be right there, quarter ball shot, right hand pocket. Looks like it's about right there. Another visual technique you can use, if you're good at it, I'm not real good at it. CTE users are probably pretty good at it. You can visualize this right edge of the cue ball lined up to the quarter, the left quarter on this 10 ball. The 1/4, halfway between the center and the edge. If I can visualize a line right there, oops, put my line back up. If I can visualize that line, then my aim point is straight over from there, just parallel to that, which puts my tip, this side of my shaft, about 3/10 of away from the edge of the ball. For me, it's easier just to aim out there in the middle of nowhere. I know it's about, if you had a piece of chalk laying out here, beside, flush against the side of the ball, a quarter ball aim would be aiming for the middle of the chalk. If it were sitting out there and I'm trying to aim right at the middle of the chalk, that's about where it would be. But so this is going to be a quarter ball shot over there. It's like this. I'm just rolling through it. You don't want to shoot thin cut shots really soft without knowing that if you shoot it soft, it's going to throw it more. So if I shoot this really soft, 10 ball's probably going to land right there, because it's the collision induced throw is going to be more friction right there when they hit. It's just going to land right here. So I'm going to roll through this with I'm not going to slam it, but I am going to roll through it with just a normal speed, a good medium stroke, and put it right in the pocket. We hope. This shot's the same way. In the middle of the table, I am 2 3-quarter intervals away from being a half ball shot. That tells me it's 2/8. 2/8 is a quarter. So it's a quarter thinner than a half ball. The next quarter out there is going to be a quarter ball, so this is it, quarter ball shot. I'm going to drug his feet a little bit. It's probably because I didn't hit it very accurately, because I'm trying to aim at a certain spot, which is how you have to learn. But the more you work with it, the more you just start whizzing balls in, and other players will be like, oh my gosh, how you doing that? It'll be hard for you to explain to them, because you'll just be doing it. And you'll just be doing it. So that's all I wanted to show. That's how the bottom rail works. Anytime there's a ball anywhere in this area, if you're lined for the center diamond, that's a half ball shot to either pocket. If you're lined for every half diamond closer to your target pocket, you aim 1/8 of a ball thicker. Well, that also means that if I were lying here, so let's set this 5 ball right there. I'm going to line this piece of chalk. So this is an in-between. If the center line were lined for here, it tells me it's a half ball shot. If it were lined for there, it tells me it's a 5/8. So this is in between a 5/8 and a half. This is where you can be creative and use your ferrule or your tip. I think Shane Van Boning talked about using his tip and splitting his tip up into fourths or quarters to help with some aiming certain shots. So from here, I know that if I split my tip on the edge of the ball, it's a half ball shot. If I put my entire tip inside the edge of the ball, it's a 5/8. So how about what I do is just put 3/4 of my tip inside the edge of the ball and 1/4 of my tip outside. So where am I aiming? I'm aiming right in between a half ball and a 5/8. That's going to be a 1/16 of a ball adjustment that I just made, and it's that easy. So from here, it's right there. I'm going to aim. There's the half. There's the 5/8. These are slight little shifts. There is in between a half and a 5/8. I'm imagining if I could stroke it all the way through there, about 1/4 of my tip is overlapping the edge of the ball and 3/4 of it is inside the ball. That's the aim. But the thing is, I know the pocket is this wide. So if this is a 5/8 and the pocket's that wide, I can probably aim at a 5/8 and make it. Or I can aim at the half ball and make it. The half ball may overcut it and the 5/8 may be a little bit thick. The further the ball is away from the pocket, the less margin you have for error. But we'll aim it like this. to slightly thicker than a half. So, I hit it too thick. I really didn't pay attention where I hit it. I was thinking about what I just said, whether or not it sounded stupid. Let's set it back up there again, somewhere in there. That's about right. Okay, so here we go. I want to pay attention here. Now I've got it. I've got what looks like a fourth of my tip is outside the edge of the ball, if I could stroke that far, and 3/4 of it is inside. We'll try that again. Okay, that was better. Conscious effort. The more you do conscious effort, the more you're not going to have to do so much conscious effort. But that's how it works. Quick video. I just got home, so now I'm going to go make some dinner. Thank you.